G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week we're going to do another fantasy composite. As you can see, we're going to create this picture that I have on the screen now, which is sort of like a space portal or space wormhole type of effect. So as usual, let's get started. We're going to start off with this picture of the clouds here. So I'm going to make a copy of that with a Command J or Control J if you're on Windows. And on this copy, I'm going to come up here to Filters, Distort, and Rectangular to Polar. And I'm going to click on that filter. And that filter is going to take a little bit of time. I've got a fairly slow computer. So we're going to get this effect here. It looks really good on this side, but not so good on this side. So what I'm going to do is take my rectangular marquee tool here, and I'm going to make a copy of just this right-hand side here. So make a selection and then Command J. So we've just got a copy of this right-hand side. So with that copy, I'm going to come up to Arrange, and I'm going to click Flip Horizontal. Come over here to my Move tool and move this across here. And you can see we've got a line down here, but if we just click on that and move the arrow, I'm just going to click my arrow to the right about four times. See if we can get rid of that line down the middle. So I'm happy with that. So these two layers now, I'm going to select both of them, holding my Shift key down, click one, hold my Shift key down and click the other one. Come up here to Layer and Merge Selected. So I've just got those two selected. I'm going to turn off this background layer for now, but I'm still going to stay on this layer here. Come over here to my Erase Brush tool, and I'm just going to erase the middle here. Just going to erase out the middle here. Just sort of take your time. Make my brush a little bit smaller. And about that should do. What I'm going to do now is come back to my Move tool. I'm just going to make this a little bit smaller using my Command Minus. And I'm just going to pull this up just so we don't see these sort of really light streaks here. We're going to cover that up a little bit later anyway, so it's not that important. But just for now, we're just going to make that a little bit smaller. I'm going to come over here to this picture here and copy that one, Command C. Come back to my picture of my clouds here, and I'm going to place this one above the background here, Command V. Still on my Move tool here, and I'm going to stretch that all the way out and then just move it back until I see this sort of the hole here. So about there looks pretty good. On this background here, I'm going to add a mask. Clicking on my mask, I want a nice soft brush. Clicking on my brush here, and I want my flow at about 10%. So just take that down to 10. I'm going to make my brush fairly big using my right and left bracket keys. I'm going to be painting in black, so I want to change this color, so I'm going to hit X on my keyboard until I get black. And then I'm going to paint some of those stars just around this picture here. And that looks pretty good, so I'm just going to leave that like that at the moment and then collapse that one. Then right on top, I'm going to come down here to Adjustments and add a Selective Color. This one here, Selective Color. Right on top here, I'm going to change this one to make sure it says Neutrals here. And then I'm just going to bump up my Cyan here to about 30. Going to drop my yellow to about minus 20 to get that sort of blue look. That looks pretty good. Let's make that a bit bigger with our Command 0 so we can see where we're at. The next picture that I'm going to bring over is going to be my landscape here. And you can see I've taken my selection brush tool and I've just made a selection all the way around just these sort of like pylons here. This is going to be my ground. So I'm just going to copy that over, Command C. Over here, back onto my picture. Now I want this just underneath this selective color here. So I'm going to click on the background here and Command V. And you can see that it's put that picture just here. So what I'm going to do is make this really small, grab my Move tool. I'm going to stretch this all the way out. And you can see it sort of flattening out a bit. And then I'm going to drop this right down the bottom. Command 0 again to make that a little bit bigger. And I'm going to make a copy of that background with Command J. And then on that bottom layer here, I'm going to come up here to Arrange and flip horizontal. And then I'm going to make that quite big in the background there. About like that's pretty good. Now we have to lift all of our portal or our wormhole here. So I'm going to click on this one, this layer, and click on this layer. And I'm going to move it up all the way up to the top. And that is looking pretty good. Okay, so we're ready now to bring over our spaceship. So I've got this spaceship here. And you can see this was the original picture here. So I've cut the spaceship out. And I've also added three textures, which are metal textures. And you can see this one here is at 25% opacity. This one here is about 96%. And then the top one is 100%. And I've just clipped all of these metal textures to the spaceship to give it this sort of rusty old color. So I'm just going to click on that and copy that, Command C, back over to the main picture. And I'm just going to paste that in between both of these backgrounds here. So these where I've created my ground here, right in between, Command V. So I've got this spaceship right in between. And when I make it bigger, it's going to go right in between both of these backgrounds. And then I'm going to bring this down and plant it about there. Maybe make it a little bit bigger. About there looks pretty good. So now we've got our spaceship in place. So now that the spaceship is under that selective color there, it's gone quite blue. So let's bring some of that rusty color back. So I'm just going to click on the selective color here, grab my brush. We've still got a soft brush, and you can see if we're going to paint in black, you can see that color coming back. So I'm just going to drop that flow to about 50%, and I'm just going to bring some of that rusty color back and leave some of the blue as well. Okay, I'm happy with that. So that looks pretty good at the moment. So let's copy this picture of the spaceship here with Command J. On the bottom one, I'm going to come down here to Layer Effects and click on Color Overlay. Make sure that's black. And with that one, I'm just going to come back to my Move tool, and I'm just going to bring that black color all the way down and then just stretch it up. Let's make that a little bit smaller. We can stretch that out just until it disappears there, and then move that back in. I'm purely just using this for a shadow underneath the spaceship. So I'm going to drop that down to about 85%, just so you can sort of see through there. And that's just the shadow. Maybe drop it down to 80. It's just the shadow that the spaceship would cast on the ground behind it. So Command 0, that's okay, back to our normal size. Let's come back to our spaceship here, and let's add an exposure. Let's clip that to our spaceship, and then let's make that darker. About there, we can always come back and play later. While I've got that exposure, I'm going to click on the exposure, grab my brush, I've still got a soft brush, and I'm going to paint in black, and you can see it's going to paint some of that light back in. So I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller, maybe take that down to about 25%. And I'm just going to make my brush smaller again, and I'm going to paint some of the light in here that would be reflecting from the wormhole here, just onto the edge here. And then make my brush a little bit bigger. Drop the flow down a little bit more, maybe 15. And then there's going to be that fall off on the end there. You can always change back to white if you think you've done too much. Okay, happy with that. So we've got our spaceship set up. Let's come to each of these backgrounds, the ground here, and add an exposure on each one of those. Clip that and bring that all the way down, making it quite dark. That's pretty good, about there. Let's do the same for the other background here. Let's add an exposure, clip it. Let's make that quite dark as well. And let's do the same we did on the spaceship. Let's click on that exposure, grab our brush, bring the flow up to about 25%. We're painting in black, so let's change that color back over and let's add some of those lights back into there again, changing our brush size. And let's just put some of that light back. About like that, not too bad. Okay, we are ready to bring over our astronauts. So let's bring over our space people here. Again, I've already cut this picture out. So let's copy that over, Command C, over to our main picture, and we want that above this background here, but under the selective color. So let's go Command V, over to our move tool, and let's make them a lot smaller, and place them sort of on the ground. About there looks pretty good. We're going to do the same to their astronauts here and add an exposure. Clip that to them and make them fairly dark. About there looks pretty good. I'm going to do the same again. So clicking still on this exposure layer, grabbing my brush, I'm going to bring that up to about 50 again, 50%. I'm going to zoom in on my astronauts here. Make my brush a little bit smaller and I'm just going to go around and add some of those highlights. Brush a little bit smaller. Okay, that looks pretty good, but what I'm going to do is just behind the astronauts here, I'm going to add a pixel layer. Going to click on white, still got my brush, but I'm going to bring my flow up to 100% and have my brush really small, and just by the astronaut's hand here, I'm just going to click once, then make this brush really big, about that big. Hold my shift key down and click, so I've got this beam going. I'll come over here to my perspective tool, and then I'm going to move this perspective, sort of like that's a torch coming out of her hand, and hit apply, just like that. Let's add another pixel layer. Let's take the flow down to 50%. Let's make our brush smaller again. So let's click in that area again where it's brightest. Make our brush big again, quite big, up to the top here, holding our shift key down and click again. This one, I'm going to grab my erase brush tool and change the flow to 50%. Brush a little bit bigger, and I'm just going to shape that just with my erase brush tool. And on that one, I'm going to drop the opacity down a little bit to about 70%, just so it looks like we've got a torch coming out of her hand there on the astronaut. And I'm sure you could just shape that a bit better than me. But that looks pretty good. So I'm happy with that at the moment. On our spaceship here, I'm going to add a pixel layer on top. I'm going to change that blend mode to overlay. I'm going to pick a really nice sort of yellow color. Back to my brush. I've still got a soft brush and I'll take the flow up to 100%. It's going to make that really quite small. I'm going to zoom in just on these sort of windows here. And I'm just going to color that yellow color on those windows and on that one. And on that layer, I'm going to add a layer effects. And I'm going to put outer glow. Turn up the radius a little bit. Turn the intensity down. And I'm going to make the color sort of that yellow color as well, and activate that. Let's just drop the opacity on that a little bit, and that looks pretty good. What I'm going to do next is add a pixel layer right on top here. I'm going to change the blend mode to overlay as well. Paint it in black at about 10% with my brush here. Let's change that flow to about 10%, not very high at all. And then just around the spaceship here, I'm just going to add another little bit of shadow just to blend that in. And a little bit here. Okay, so now we've got our shadow in place and our spaceship in place. Let's just add on top of our portal here another exposure. Just drop that exposure a little bit as well. That looks pretty good. So I'm pretty happy with that. So what I might do is just select all of these layers. So I'm going to click on the top one all the way down to the bottom, holding my shift key down. I'm going to come up here to layer and merge visible. I'm going to come over here and click on the develop persona. And on the basic, I'm going to up the clarity a little bit, maybe to 45. Bring down the contrast a tiny bit. Bring up the saturation and the vibrance. Exposure down a little bit. On the details, I'm going to click on the details, bring those up to about 50 each. And on the noise, maybe take that to about 5. Come over here and hit develop. A couple of more things I might do is come down here to my adjustments, add that lens filter on top, and then on adjustments again, come to my curves. Might just bring the middle down a little bit, making that S curve up a little bit, and then drop the blacks a bit. And the very last thing I'm going to do on this picture is add this picture of the stars. Going to copy that over with a command C, over to the picture, right on top, command V, and then I'm going to change the blend mode to color dodge. There we go, everybody. That is my tutorial for this week. I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial as much as I have enjoyed making it for you. If you did love the tutorial, please consider subscribing to my channel. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when I upload my next video. And once again, if you would like to show your appreciation, you can head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site and you can do that there. But until next time, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe. And I'll see you in the next video.